Welcome back to H3 Weapon Deep Dive. We are taking a look at the FAMAS, a pair of FAMASes today. We are here in home SMG rifle carbine FAMAS F1. We're looking at the F1 and the new G2, well, new-ish G2. What is the difference? Not a lot visually, except that the trigger area is different. You can see it's got a different grip and a different front trigger guard, that kind of thing. But the main difference as far as H3 is concerned is that the G2, the newer one, takes a Stanag mag. The older one, where is it? There it goes. The older one has its own bespoke mag, this F1 mag. Dunk. So with the G2, you got a lot more options as far as magazines go. So that said, let's check them out. Take a look at the controls on the F1. It's a bullpup rifle. Here is our magwell in the back. That's our 25 round F1 magazine. This is the one that does not take Stanags. Here's our bolt handle right down the middle. Nice and ambidextrous. Here's your little, yeah, see, there it is. And then left on the trackpad, we'll change our little selector switch. We've got three to choose from. We've got safe. That is not safe. That is safe. So down the center line there is safe. One click for semi. And another click gets you repetition. So you can switch between three round burst and full auto, but it's not left on the trackpad. It is a separate manual switch that you have to click with your offhand here. This will switch between three round burst here at three and full auto at the zero position. So here's three round burst. And then full auto. So now, if I use left on the trackpad, I can go between safe, semi, whoops, semi, and full, because it's in the full position. Now it's back in the three round burst position. There we go. There is no mag release. Pressing down on the trackpad does nothing, but you can just grab the magazine, throw it up, insert it yourself. Now, unfortunately, it does not lock open on empty, so you've got to manually actuate the bolt. Pressing up on the trackpad does nothing. So every time, you've got to pull out magazine and do the bolt manually. I looked for a bolt release, and I can't find it. It's surprising, but I can't find it there. So if you can find it, let me know, but it's hidden if it's there. Anyway, it's also got a bipod. If you're wondering what these big things are, if you click over here where this little hinge is, you can extend the bipod. There we go. Now, bipods kind of work automatically in H3. If you get near a surface like this, you can see they kind of glue themselves to the surface. And then if you pull it away, they will snap back. Click it again to deploy and undeploy it. How handy is that? Let's look at the G2. Well, the controls are the same. The only difference is the magazine. Now we can take Stanag mag. So in this case, we've got a 30 rounder in there instead of the 25 we had before. Still won't lock open on empty. Still no mag release. Still no bolt release. So boo on all that. But it's got the same two-part trigger selector switch, rather. There's your semi. There's your full auto because it's in the full auto position. Here's your three-round burst. Because it's in the three-round burst position, you get the deal. It's the same other than the magazine. Let's see what attachments will fit. Well, what do we got here? Let's start with rails. Well, it's got this giant thing on the top, which would be perfect for rails, except there's no rails on it, but there is a rail adapter. So you can get this FAMAS rail adapter on there, and now you've got a rail on top, and you can put whatever you'd like up there. Put a red dot. Boy, that's some serious height above the bore, isn't it? Well, at least you can use it. Okay, what else can we do here? How many other rails can we put on here? I don't think there's any other rail spots anywhere on here. No, so that's a bummer. Let's see what will go on the barrel. How about a muzzle brake? Yep, muzzle brake replaces that big little flash hider looking thing. Where's my suppressor? Hey, you can put a suppressor on there. Gotta like that. Barrel extension, yep, looks good. How about our adapter? Oh, so we can put rails on that way. How about a stock? Well, it's already got a stock on it. How about foregrip? Nope, no special foregrip area or anything like that, so that will limit it, but at least you got this handy rail adapter. Let's take a look at the G2. Well, same stuff, I believe, on the G2. You still don't have any rails, even though this is updated a bit, so that's unfortunate, but the rail adapter will work just the same. Still goes on top, still no spot for foregrips. Let's double check the barrel. Yep, muzzle brake. Yep, suppressor. Yep. Ah, come here. Extension, rail adapter, all that stuff will work just fine. And of course, no stock. So yeah, the attachments are the same for both. Again, the only difference seems to be the magazine. Let's look at our sights, starting with the F1. Here are our sights. Well, that is a large rear aperture. Got a big one. You've got these giant, the giant gutter down this, I guess it's a carry handle. Either that or it's just there to protect the bolt handle. But yeah, so there's a small forward post and a giant rear aperture. So that is easy to kind of sight in like that. I don't know how accurate that's going to be, but at least you can see it pretty well. Let's see what we can get here. So you got quite a bit of a height over the bore. You can see I'm missing quite low, so that's going to be a problem. Let's see what else we've got here. We've got actual two other apertures. So if you click just forward of that large aperture, you can bring that one up. And if you click to the rear, you can bring that one up. So you get this. I think this is the next step up. Yeah, so that's a little smaller. Well, it's actually quite a bit smaller. And then if you click on the forward one, you get a smaller one still. Whoa, I can't even find the post. There it is. All right, still shooting low. But we've got adjustable sights. And again, if we put the rail on there, now we can put whatever we want on it. And we're so far above anything. We could put low profile red dots on there. We can put whatever we want. Oh, that looks that works a lot better. Okay, that'll work. Let's look at the sights on the G2. They are, whoopsie, they are the same. They're exactly the same sights. We've got the same three apertures to choose from. There we go. Oof, hard to shoot through on full auto like that. But yeah, we've got the same choices on the G2. Let's double check with the rail adapter and, hey, turkey. Rail adapter and my red dot. Looking good. Yeah, much easier. Ahaha. There we go. Recoil test. Gonna do the F1, 25 rounds of 5.56 by 45 NATO. Let's do it. Well, not too shabby. 7.84 on a very high rate of fire. There's our 25 rounds in there. Not too bad. Let's try it with our muzzle brake. Whoa, 9.88. Wait, what? Holy smokes. 1, 2, 3 nines, and the rest are tens. We got to get that up close. Whoa. I'd say the muzzle brake helps. Oh, buddy. I like this. Let's try the suppressor. Not nearly as good as the muzzle brake, but 8.4 is numerically superior. And look, we're still coming back into the 10 ring after about the 12th and 13th round, still in the 9. So this definitely improves it. May not show too much on the numbers, but it definitely improved it. Well, I was just going to show the F1, thinking that the recoil is going to be the same on the G2, but considering how well it did, I'm going to go ahead and do the G2 and see if there's any significant differences. Here we go. Okay, a couple tens, then starts to drift after about, what, the 10th round, somewhere in there. So a 7.93, pretty close to what we got with the F1. Okay, now here's where things get interesting. Let's try it with the muzzle brake. Well, it started off really good, but then we did drift down. 9.63, though. That is... look at that. So they picked back up into the tens. This is fantastic with the muzzle brake on it. Ooh, and quite good with it. With the not muzzle brake on it. Yeah. Finally, let's try it with a suppressor. Bit of a climb. Climbed out there, 783. So actually not so hot on that particular run with the suppressor. But still quite good. All right, since the recoil numbers look the same, I'm going to do the G2 with the bipod only. But here we go with the bipod. Well, 8.8, so that is better. There's a lot more tens on there. I was hoping for a little bit more with the bipod, but, you know, numerically, that's pretty good. All right, bipod and our muzzle brake. Hmm, 8.67. That wasn't very good. I'm not too impressed with this bipod. Finally, let's do our suppressor and the bipod here. Ugh, 8.6. I mean, they're still good numbers, but there don't seem to be any sort of recoil improvement with the bipod. It does seem to be a little easier to aim, like the filtering's a little stronger with the bipod, but the recoil seems to be exactly the same. So I would kind of skip the bipod, to be honest. There you have it, the pair of FAMASes, the F1 and the G2 with the Stanag mags. Unfortunate manual controls on here, but amazing recoil. Until next time, I will see ya. Okay, maybe not recoil so great when you're not holding the foregrip, but what do you expect?